Thailand, Cambodia, Singapore, two artists in the exhibition Concept Context Contestation. And we're going to talk a little bit about their process and how they work, how they develop an idea for the work, and then how they proceed to make the work, and to what extent they think about their audience, the reception that the work will have. Bearing in mind that both Vasan and Sitthiket make works that engage the public, that are not formal for the sake of form, but have social content, political content. So Vasan, perhaps you can tell us a little bit about this.
First, we're talking about a teacher. And so we could have experience about the art and now in Bangkok, a marching and demonstration of the people to again the government and the collapsed government. So first he really come here, and so I said you have to go to hotel. And so he wants to go to Hyde Park. So as the time I had planning to make dog skin, because in the Thai culture, if somebody do bad thing for society or family or your life, so you have to write down the name, their name, the kind of person that on the dog skin, like in the hill. In the hill, the Thai believe that in the hill, the name of a person who do bad thing, it's they call them on
a dog skin. This is the tradition.
Yeah. So but there, next day I organize a big, make 10 meters by 7 meters on the make the paper for the newspaper.
So, in other words, for you, you have some idea, but very important that the people join in this artwork.
Yes, because I think it, people have their opinion, so they want to say. I think I have always made for the people to join, to speak out, their voice.
Yeah, that's very important. Would you say, Sitthiket, that in Singapore people are able to voice their opinions, political opinions, and if not, is art a conduit for that?
This question was in Singapore.
Yeah.
I would say it's a big contrast.
Oh, yeah.
According to the laws, we can't protest openly. There's only a fixed venue for you, the only apartment itself.
One single venue.
Which you have to register for.
In other words, you have to get the authorization of the authorities in order to even say something.
I would say it's very restricted compared to
Thailand.
To Thailand, so you can just do it freely.
So you've been very happy here. It's been a big, very rather exotic for you in some ways.
Not exotic, but you know, that's the way it should be.
Sure.
Freedom of expression.
No, I didn't mean exotic, like dancing clubs or something. I meant just very different. So you've encouraged, do you think that art can help in Singapore? For example, your the other Singapore story, of course, is a way of going underneath the gate, as it were, in terms of trying to give expression to certain ideas that you would not normally be allowed to express.
You're referring to the other Singapore story.
Yeah, Toss series that's being shown in this exhibition.
Yeah, I would say that. This is, you can say this is my first explicit politics engagement. First time. That I would do explicit, direct speaking about what our political
quiz and your critique of that?
Well, produce images, you know,
Yeah. But Vasan, you have been making political art all your life, in fact. You're a specialist, I would say, in some ways. And yet, you still both consider, I mean, Vasan, despite the fact that your work is often activist art, still art is the main thing. Can you tell us a little bit about, you know, how, why, instead of going in the street constantly, you still consider that art is a good way to talk to people about these ideas?
As a person who living in this society, so I have my experience about I have talents and my skill, and I been interacting in why I have rules. We live in the same society and have a rule. So if as the light of individual life, if I accept to live in the society, so if the injustice law, something happened in our society, the effect on to me too. Mm-hmm. And any a problem, every problem it affects to me, because if someone hungry, one hungry, so he want to rob something. Mm. So he not rob me, he rob anybody.
Sure.
So I have a
problem. So it's your problem also.
Like a shed, I have a problem.
Sure.
So I think I can do ask like this is our society. Mm-hmm. I hope I try to open everything to our society to learn what I was thinking about, what I have a dream about to change it or something.
Sure.
My art, the poem, as music, or any kind of I can do.
Now, you have had a collaboration now going for several weeks. Is the strength in numbers? I mean, you're, of course, you're bringing two perspectives to the same table. What do you think you achieved more artistically doing it this way, and indeed have you achieved more perhaps in terms of engagement of the outside world and these ideas?
Well, it's a great experience, it's a learning experience, and also a different experience. Strategy. It should be in many other countries with political freedom.
But do you not think that in Singapore the role of the artist could be greater, that artists could adopt this role of pushing forward and being at the forefront of reform and change?
Yeah, but then you would be termed as one art activist and you would be, you know...
Then you would not get funding from NAC, but isn't that a risk of... Maybe. But then maybe I wonder, Vasan, when you were starting as a young artist in the late 70s, whether you took that risk, you were prepared to take that risk. You did many times, right?
Yes, because in 14 October in
73,
we started a Thai student liberation. So that I'm 16 years old.
16.
So one station, try the one station in my body, in house. And so I tell thinking about the politics. And so I learned that. And so 2 years later, I come to study art in Bangkok. Go to Bangkok. So I bought in the flame. I bought in the village. And so I go to a big city. So you have ice. I saw the gap between the poor and the least. And so I think that I have injustice in our society. And so at 1976, in 6 October, so they have a massacre of students. And at that time, I went my friend joined them and in jail. And so I studied in the first year in art school. And at that time, I have awake. I think it went. People have to join with the revolution. Because they use the violence to kill the very innocent.
In a peaceful.
Because young children at that time, 18 years old, 17 years old, they dream about they want to, they ask for the democracy, they want to revolution. Mm. But the planning of the power, running to shoot them. Someone said in the radio that okay, if Thailand may be better if they kill 30,000 students. And so they plan step, and later to shoot them 3 years later. And so it make it, I think it's okay, art is very important thing because in a Thai, no record, I think it poem, the poem, the writer, artists, we can record our history, the history of the people, the history of the structure of the people. Mm-hmm. Very important for our society can learn from art, object, and story, or something like that. Mm-hmm. And so I love to do that. I sacrifice my work to support this.
Of course, in the tradition of Thailand, Buddhist murals and didactic art has always existed. So perhaps there's a tradition here where people do look at art to get knowledge, to get wisdom. But going back to the Singapore, comparing to the Singapore situation, I think the point is that there was a risk and the artist took the risk.
So I have many problems about the culture, so the conflict. I think, so I have a lot of questions in my mind. So I make, I want the people to think about ourselves, about our culture, so I can think. I like watching, look at ourselves, so hitting ourselves, hitting our culture, hitting power, everything.
Yeah, what do you think about that?
Well, I would say for all professions, I mean, not only the artists, but NGOs who work in Singapore,
sure.
Have been more vocal than before. Mm-hmm. Well, I would say for all professions, they should really speak up. I mean,
yeah, sure. Everyone should be speak up. Yeah, sure. Sure, not just artists.
But for artists, maybe there's more effective. It's just that.
Yeah. Well, they said art is public. I mean, the point being, when you're speaking to many, assuming you're making work for many people, not for the gallery elite, but for the street, then it should be more effective. Well, precisely.
Not just aesthetics.
Of course. But this is, you see, this is one of the points of this exhibition, to show that that's actually one of the big main ideas of Southeast Asian culture that carries through to the contemporary art, is that artists continue to make work that is about function, and as a point. It's not just a form, as you say, games, playing games, kind of thing, which is quite different to Western or European art, where a lot of postmodern art is really about being having a sort of effect, a visual effect, or but art for art's sake, not art for social sake. So I think you've probably answered the question. So I hope you have a very productive collaboration this afternoon with the people in Bangkok. And thank you very much for speaking to us today.